Okay, so we got the boat mower here today. This is the boat. Beautiful boat. Look at, we're running low in the water. Got a problem with the mower. When we turn it on, this is what you hear. Like nothing. It's seized up, basically. So, actually it's not plugged in. Okay, so the mower motor has seized up on us. When we hit the power, this is what you hear. That's a sign, I can smell it burning. Let's see what we can do here. Let's record how it's connected first of all. So we've got our connections here. Looks like this one goes to that side of the motor. This other connection here goes to the switch. So this connection here goes up to the switch for the toggle on off, which then connects up this way. We got some other stuff going on here. Something, this wire wraps around. Where did that go to? Oh, that's the power, okay. I guess that's the power. That was kind of weird. So it goes under, power comes in up this way. So this is where the power is actually. The power is connected to these three. We've got three, a white, a black in the back, and a green ground at the end. So the power comes in here. And then I guess this is because I got power up on the top. So the power comes in and then it comes off this way. We've got power here and power there. So that's what's going on here. All right, let's go see if we can fix this thing up. Let's open it up, get it off. So this motor really has rusted bad. We put power on it and it hummed, and then when I put a wrench on the nut and forcefully turned it, it loosened up, but it just clanged, and actually some fire came out and sparks when I put power on it. The fan did turn, but it was obviously, I think the bearings had corroded. And it was really, really bad. A lot of fire, smoke, sparks. So we opted to take out this motor and put a shop vac on it to raise the boat, and then we ordered a new one. So this is how you inflate and raise your boat lift when you take out the motor. Use a shop vac. You blow air out and you connect it right there. And I'll tell you a little bit about the technique. You take a piece of paper towel, you fold it up a little bit, and then you wrap it around the outside of your shop vac just so you get enough so it can get a snug fit inside that rubber hose that's going to attach it to your boat lift. There's the rubber hose with two metal clamps. You put the end of the shop vac hose into that with the paper towel to give it just the right diameter. So we're able to change out our motor here. This is the air pump. So all we did was we bought the motor on Amazon. Motor exactly like this one. You'll see it listed. It's for boat lifts. It's a blower motor. This one costs about $80. It's gonna last a long time until it rusts out. The wire is this one black wire. It goes up to the switch underneath. The other wire goes into right there.
there goes upwards. I ended up just attaching it. Any way you can attach it, attach it. And then you flip the switch. You check if you can hear blowing out by opening up this release here. And then checking if air is coming out of this part here. If it is, you've got it. Got the electric hooked up the correct way, and then that's it. Then you raise your boat, and your boat's gonna go up. There it is. So we're using a bottoms up boat lift here. And let's show you what it does. That is it.